Type designers put an enormous amount of effort, care, and attention to detail into their fonts. A large part of what makes them unique and gives them that personalized touch is something called stylistic alternates, also known as alternate characters, alternate glyphs, or ligatures. These are basically just different options of the letter forms that are supplied with the font. So in addition to the standard character set, there might be flourishes that work really well at the end of a word, or potentially there's some ascenders that will work really well in the middle of the word, or descenders that finish the composition really nicely. There might be two or three variations of the capital letters supplied. You can swap out these letters depending on what works best for your own composition and layout. Unfortunately, Procreate doesn't have the ability to view these characters, so we either miss out entirely or we have to rely on the assistance of other software such as Affinity Designer or even an expensive Adobe subscription. Until now, because I'm about to share a free website I found which unlocks the entire glyph library of any font. You can basically scroll through the list, and once you find the character you want, you tap on it to copy it and just paste it straight into Procreate. If you want to start using beautiful open type fonts like this, I've dropped a link in the description below. It's a free resource you can download that takes you through the steps of how to use this website and also gives you my top 10 fonts that have a wide range of alternate characters for inspiration. Okay, so let's get into it and see how easy it is to use these alternate characters in Procreate. Before we dive in, I just want to show you an example of what you can do. So you can make some really beautiful custom designs using these alternate characters. This gold foil card was a project part of my new Procreate course. And you can see I'm using these alternate characters here, as well as some design elements that were also included in the font. The only thing that wasn't included are these stars. I was able to put together this design completely from the font. So you can see I've got some plain text here, and when we're finished, it will be easy to go from that to this without using any of our own hand-drawn elements. And then you can even take your design further, bring in imagery, and really enhance it. This was something you can do in a matter of 10 or 15 minutes. So the first thing that you need to do is have the particular font that you've chosen installed into Procreate. The easiest way is to unzip the font files and copy them directly into your Procreate fonts folder. And to get to that, you just go on my iPad, then you're in Procreate and in fonts. And if you paste your fonts in there, they'll automatically be available in Procreate. So basically you just need to load up a website called Font Cloud. And as I mentioned, it's completely free. So just register and you'll get a free profile with them. And I believe they give you 2 gigabytes of data free with that. Once you're here, you just scroll down to the bottom and there's a little button called Browse, tap on Choose Files, and then I'm going to go directly into my Procreate Fonts folder, and then I'm just going to scroll down and find the ones I want. And you'll see that you can select several at a time. So I'm going to choose the whole Lost and Master family there. We've got light, bold, extra bold. I'm going to select them all and then just choose Open. And if you just watch the left-hand side here, you can see these loading up. So once they're loaded, they'll also appear in this preview area here. And I'm going to just select on, I'm using black for my design. So I'm going to open the black version and just scroll through. And I can see all these alternate characters really easily. But I know that I've got a U that I want to use a flourished version for. So I'm going to scroll right down and just see what options I've got. So I can see this curl to the U. That's what I want to put on the first line. Just simply tap on the letter. Doesn't really look like anything's happened. Nothing visual changes. I can just simply tap on that first word. I'm going to choose Edit Text, which will bring me into the Edit Text menu. I'm just going to select. It'll select the whole word. I want just the U selected because that's all I'm replacing. I'll choose Paste and then Allow Paste. And there you have it. It's as easy as that. We've got our beautiful U here. I'm also going to see if there's a version of the Y I can use. And another thing you can do is just utilize the split screen feature of your iPad. So you could even bring it in split screen. And when you're looking for your character, you can sort of make Procreate the smaller version. I found one there that I'd like to use. So I just tap on it to copy. Now I'm going to reduce that window, come back into Procreate, but we'll paste that character and it remains in text form. And the beauty of that remaining in text form means that I can enlarge and reduce this without any loss in quality. So you can still play around with the layout without any loss in quality. If you've got the move tool selected, you can see the bounding box with the little marching ants, they're called. That just means that you're in transform mode, you can move it, and you're not in text mode. So if you want to be interacting with the characters via text mode, just tap off the move tool and then tap on the text again. And once you see that solid line, that now means that you can select your text just by striking through it. And then you adjust what you've got selected by these little blue nodes. They tell you the start of the selection and the end of the selection. So if you want the Y, you just need to pull this last one right down. So let's go on to the next line. So I'll look for a flourished N. Just enlarge my screen on the other side so I can see it a bit better. You might not like using this split screen. Sometimes it can be a little fiddly. So if you don't want to use split screen, you know, you can just move between your windows just by swiping up. And I see my N, I'm going to tap on it to copy it. Make sure the N is selected, choose paste, and then allow paste. Okay, so that's looking good. I'm happy with the character alternate versions that I'm using in the flourishes. So I'm just going to close the window for a moment and take a look here. I'm using Lost to Master again. I've dropped a link below to this font. Something else that this font provides, which is super cool, is a whole nother character set with ornaments. So they are purely just ornaments instead of the letters. And if you want to access those, basically you just add any text. So we're going to come into the actions menu and add text. Basically, you can come into this double A down the bottom, which will bring up your font panel. And you can see I've got Lost to Master, which is the font we're using. This top style here, it doesn't look like anything recognizable, but if you tap on it, it's actually ornaments. So rather than letter forms, they've supplied ornaments. So you'll see if I type an N, M, K, L, it's coming out as different ornaments. But it's a little tricky to go through the whole alphabet and see what's available. So Font Cloud does come in handy there as well. I have my ornaments here. Tap on that on the left and I can see all the ornaments available to me. So I'm going to find the one I want. I just tap on it. So now I'll come back and I'll select the character just like before and I'll choose paste. And now I've got my beautiful flourish and I can enlarge it without losing any quality and just place it wherever I'd like on the designs. And it just finishes the design really nicely. But something worth mentioning, say you had characters here and you had them in the medium typeface instead of ornaments. And we know that we just copied the ornament before, and I choose paste here, it will display in the typeface that's chosen. So if you wanted to use the ornament, you need to make sure that the characters that you've got selected on the screen are actually the ornament style. So that's just one thing to keep in mind. So let's do a few more of these flourishes. So there you go. It's as easy as that to transform your designs and make them feel really personal and handmade. I've got a new Procreate course coming out all about how to design gold foil cards, and there's a big module in there about using these alternate characters. So if that sparked your interest and you want to learn more, there's a link below to sign up to the waitlist. You'll be the first to know when it's open, as well as first dibs on a limited supply of a very special mystery gift. So check that link below. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial today. Take care and I'll catch you next time.